kind of V-shaped. But when she compared it with the tissue itself, under stretch, she found that the frenum is not a V-shape. Okay? Yes, the answer is yes. Because, first of all, we have a lot of anatomical variations in patients. Now, remove the tray, please. And let. Okay, so you have opened a V-shape. But when she compared it with the ridge, she found that the frenum is not a V-shape. It's like an area. And this is actually a muscular attachment. If you come closer here. Yes. Do you see? It's a wide area and multiple frenoid attachments. This is what's different between the buccal and the labial. The labial, usually it's a single line, a thin, and in the middle. You see it's single, thin, because it's fibrous attachment. But this one is a buccal muscular attachment, okay? It comes from the modulus, as we said. So that means when you trim it here, your question was, how am I going to trim it? It's not an actual V-shape. If you have two prominent frenoid, yes, I could make two V-shapes, okay? But if I don't have them, I have the multiple fibers and I cannot really actually confine them, simply I just make a wide U-shape opposite to them, okay? So this is how I trim around buccal frenoid.